how to make the sample. Okay, so first we will look on it, what ingredients are necessary to make the shampoo. So first one is the main ingredient is your sodium lauryl sulfate, then coconut diethanolamide, ethylene glycol stearate, sodium chloride and water. Okay, so first what we will do, we will take a small quantity of water. Okay, so first you have to weigh the ingredient according to how much formulation you wanted to make. Okay, so you have to take a small quantity of water and dissolve the sodium lauryl sulfate in that water quantity. So we have added the sodium lauryl sulfate in a small quantity of water. So next step is you have to add a small sodium chloride in the formulation. So it's a quantity sufficient. You can add a little amount of sodium chloride in the water. Sodium chloride usually we are adding in a shampoo to provide a better cleaning and for the longevity of the cleaning, because sodium chloride will remove all the oil from the scalp. Okay, so the next step is we have to take the fatty content ethylene glycol monostearate in a beaker along with the coconut diethanolamide, and we have to melt it. Melt the oily ingredient. So you can see it's melting here. Okay. You can see here your oily content is about to melt. Our oily ingredient is already melted. So we will add the small quantity of sodium lauryl sulfate solution in it and mix it. Okay, because your sodium lauryl sulfate solution is at room temperature, so you can feel like when you are adding it will it may cause some congealing. So what you have to do, you have to add your solution in a small portion and mix the oily content. Meanwhile, on the another hand, we will heat our water content. Here you can see a smooth texture is coming out. Here you can see the smooth texture is there. So our water phase is also heated up to 60 degrees, because if you add directly, what will happen, whatever oily phase you have, it will congeal faster. So we have to heat it little, so when you will add water phase into the oily phase, it will not congeal. So we will add our water phase. Now we have mixed all the things. To make a smooth structure, we will stir it by using stirrer. Now we will stir it for a few minutes to make a smooth structure. So shampoo is not thick as the conditioner, it will be like a little bit flowy formulation compared to your conditioner. Now you can see the shampoo came into the room temperature and the texture is a bit thicky and off the stirrer. Now we see the consistency. When you see the consistency is very good here. It's very thick and uniform in texture. The flowability is more compared to the conditioner. The conditioner is more thicky because they have a more oil content in it. So here you can see your shampoo is ready. So if you want to add any of the fragrance, then you can add any of the fragrance in it according to your choice. So now our shampoo is ready, but before we use this shampoo we have to check the pH of this shampoo because we have added a large quantity of sodium lauryl sulfate. Okay, so here is our pH meter. Here we can see the pH is around 8. You can see here the pH of our formulation is around 8.32. So we have to neutralize, we have to make our shampoo at the neutral pH. So what we will do, we will add a few drops of orthophosphoric acid. Okay, and we have to mix it. Mix it properly. Here you can see the pH is decreasing. So now we can see our pH is around 7. So that means our formulation is ready. So now we have to we have adjusted our pH at the neutral pH. So now your shampoo is ready to use. So hope you have enjoyed this session.